Good morning, students. In our chapter number 8, Animals, How Life Goes On, we discussed that animals, they have the ability to produce their young ones, or they have the ability to produce their same kinds. That is called reproduction. Reproduction is of two kinds. One is that animals give birth to their babies. Their babies grow inside the mother's body, and when they are born, they feed on a mother's milk, and then slowly they grow after they are taken care by their mother, especially mother, and also sometimes the father. Other type of reproduction is when animals like birds, fish, crocodile, reptiles, and insects, they lay eggs, and their eggs are hatched and the young ones come out. So in this way we studied that birds, they lay their eggs are given some warmth by their mother bird, and that is called incubation. And after a period of 21 days, the egg which gets the warmth is hatched, and the baby bird or the chick comes out. The birds, they build their nest to lay their eggs, and they take care of their eggs. Okay, so in this way, this different ways of reproduction we have studied. Children, let us do a small exercise which is given in the next page, and that is your oral question, page number 70 in your science textbook. Page number 70, oral question. These are the questions given here. Let us do. This is a multiple choice question where the options are given. You have to choose the correct ones. Birds, mammals, reptiles are the most developed among all animals. We have discussed, children, that mammals, the animals that give birth to their babies, are the most developed animals in this whole animal kingdom. So our answer will be mammal, and I will circle it. Who are mammals? Children, remember that. Mammals are animals that give birth to their babies, isn't it? Birds, as you all know, and reptiles, you know that snake, lizard, they are the reptiles. Okay? So mammals are the most developed one. Number two, the eggs of birds contain a growing baby called embryo, chick, or larva. So you have to find out the correct answer. I know just now we have done that when a baby chick, it grows in the yolk, as we discussed, that the egg has the outer shell which is little hard, and then inside you have that white portion which is called albumen, and inside the white portion you have the small yellow, that is yolk. Baby chick, till it is hatched and coming out, it grows in that yolk, and it gets all its food from the yolk, and it grows, and the warmth of the mother bird is given, and it hatches after 20, and that small chick comes. So the eggs of the birds grow, and they are at that time, they are not called the chick, they are called embryo. So remember this, the eggs of the birds contain a growing baby. A baby is growing inside the egg, inside the egg, internal part of the egg, and at that time it is called embryo. But when it comes out, when it is hatched and come out, then it is called a chick. Okay? Coming to the third one, in a bird's egg, the yolk or the albumen or shell contains the stored food for the chick. Just now I discussed that the embryo gets all its food when it is inside the egg, it is growing, and for development it needs food. As I told you, the mammal give birth to their babies, but the baby is inside the mother's body, so it gets the food which the mother eats. But here the egg, in an egg, the chick, but at that time it is not a chick, it is growing inside the egg, it is called an embryo. An embryo gets all its food from that yolk. Okay? I-O-N-K, yolk, not the albumen or the shell. So embryo gets all its food from the yolk. Okay, so I circle it. So just quickly, I'll just do a recap. Number one, mammals are the most developed among all animals. Number two, the eggs of birds contain growing baby called embryo. And third one, in a bird's egg, the yolk contains the stored food for the chick. The chick at that stage is called embryo, and it gets all its food from the yolk, not albumen or shell. It's only the outer covering. So children, these are your mammals, different type of mammals we discussed. Mammals, the animals that live on land, some animals like whale and dolphin, they live in water, but they are mammals. We have studied that all, like seal, walrus, they also live in water, but they are the mammals. Even the bats, the flying bats are the mammals. Okay, so different animals and all. This is the world of animals, the world of mammals. Okay, as we discussed, the mammals also, they have to give warmth to their babies. When the babies are born, they are too small. They need the warmth of their mother, they need food from their mother, and they are protected from their enemies. Mothers, they protect their babies from the enemies and teach them how to live, how to hunt, how to find food for themselves. All these are mammals, children. This is all mammals. As you can see, small animals, big animals, all type of, even the monkeys. Okay, all mammals, insect eating mammals, even your rats and rodents, flying mammals that are the bats. Mighty mammals, elephants, animals on the hoof, even the cattle family, all mammals, the zebras, giraffes. Okay? All are water mammals. Okay, water mammals, as we discussed, ocean mammals. You can see dolphin and the whale that live in oceans. So all these are mammals, okay, and they give birth to their babies. And eggs, already I have shown to you, the birds that live, build their nest to lay their eggs, and eggs are given, and then the chick coming out, already discussed with you. Thank you, children.